treadmill test. A treadmill test used to determine how well your heart responds during times when it's working its hardest. During the test, you will be asked to exercise, typically on a treadmill, while you are hooked up to an ECG machine. Stress test involves exercising while your heart and blood pressure is monitored. When you are ready, you will begin walking on the treadmill. Every 2 to 3 minutes, the speed or inclination of the treadmill will gradually be increased. You will not be asked to exercise more than you are able to. Any changes in your mental status, blood pressure, or pattern of heartbeats will be known to the doctor. You should also let your doctor know immediately if you have any chest pain or unusual shortness of breath. The exercise will be stopped immediately if you are having any of these symptoms or if you are clearly showing signs of heart disease. The stress test usually takes about 8 to 12 minutes. This allows our technician to monitor your heart rate. The treadmill test is also called an exercise stress test. This test is primarily used to help your doctor determine if your heart receives enough oxygen and proper blood flow when it needs it the most, that is when you are exercising. It can be ordered for people who have been experiencing chest pain or any other symptom of coronary heart disease. An exercise stress test or a treadmill test may also be used to help determine your level of health, especially if you are starting a new exercise program. This allows your doctor to learn what level of exercise you can safely handle. If you are a smoker or over 40 years old, or if you have any other risk factor for heart disease, you should talk to your doctor to see if an exercise stress test is a good idea for you. Treadmill tests are generally considered safe, and especially since they are done in a controlled environment under the supervision of a trained medical professional. However, your risk of experiencing some reactions during the test is low, since your doctor will screen you for problems beforehand. People who run the risk of these complications, such as those with advanced coronary heart disease, are rarely asked to do this test. Prior to your test, your doctor will perform a physical exam and ask about your complete medical history. At this point, tell your doctor about your symptoms, especially any chest pain or shortness of breath. You should also tell your doctor about any condition or symptoms that may make exercising difficult, such as stiff joints from arthritis. Finally, let your doctor know if you have diabetes, because exercise affects blood sugar. If you do have diabetes, your doctor may have want to monitor your blood glucose level during the exercise test as well. On the day of the test, be sure to dress in loose, comfortable clothing. Something that is light and breathable is the best. Make sure to wear comfortable shoes such as athletic sneakers. Your doctor will give you complete instructions as to how to prepare for the test. These instructions might include to avoid eating, smoking, or drinking caffeinated beverages for 3 hours before the test and to stop taking certain medications. Report any chest pain or any other complication you notice on the day of the test. You should only stop taking medications if your doctor tells you to do so. Before you begin exercising, you will be hooked up to an ECG machine. Several sticky pads will be attached to your skin under your clothes. Your doctor or nurse will check your heart rate and breathing before you begin exercising. Your doctor may also have you to breathe into a tube to test the strength of your lungs. You will have to start off by walking slowly on the treadmill. The speed and the grade of the treadmill will be increased as the test continues. If you experience any difficulties, especially chest pain, weakness, or fatigue, you may ask to stop the test. When your doctor is satisfied with your results, you will be able to stop exercising. Your heart rate and breathing will continue to be monitored for a short while afterwards. After the test, you will be given water and asked to rest. If your blood pressure rises during the test, your attending nurse may continue to monitor your blood pressure.
Scans and labs. Yindrum, ungal nalanukkaga.